Good morning, students. As we were discussing the word used as different parts of speech in English language, let us do another exercise which is given in your grammar practice as a part of revision work in your workbook, and it is in page number 80. Children, let us do exercise number E, page number 80 of your English workbook. Identify the part of speech of the underlined word in the given sentence. As you can see, the sentences are written, the words are underlined. You have to find out which part of speech do they belong to. The first one, as you can see, in number 1, we have 3 sentences, A, B and C. And the first one, the early bird catches the worm. Yes, and this is actually a proverb that if you are very agile and you are alert and you do your work in time and you are early riser, you will of course succeed in life. You don't be lethargic, you don't be lazy, okay? So early bird, here early is underlined. As you can see, bird is a noun, and if I am talking about bird, and that bird, early bird means the birds who do their work early, they find out their food early, they don't have to worry much. So here early is telling you more about the bird, which is a noun, so it is an adjective. As you can see, I have written that it is an adjective. You also have to write adjective. Coming to the second one, number B, try to come early tomorrow. And again you see early is underlined, and it is telling you more about come, isn't it? Come when? When should I come tomorrow? You should come tomorrow early, okay? You can come, don't be late, okay? So this come is a verb, and early is telling you more about the verb, so it is an adverb. It is an adverb. Coming to the third sentence, that is sentence number C, she rode back early. Now here you can see early is telling you back that how, when did I enroll, when she rode back, when she went back, she went back early. It is giving you more about an adverb. Back is a, road is a verb, back is an adverb, and it is again describing more about a, an adverb. So it is another adverb. Adverbs are the modifiers, and they modify a verb, an adjective, also an adverb. So it is telling you more about this. Now rode back, when you mean she rode back, she rode back early. So it is also an adverb. Okay, coming to the second sentence, again you see second sentence also have 3 subdivisions, and 3 sentences are, number A, he has much work to do. Much, we have done in degree of adjective, remember, many, more, most, much, more, most. So this much, much work, work here is a noun, it is not a verb. Whenever you see work, you don't think that it is a verb. Work can be used as noun, as a verb, both. So here work is noun. So it is telling you about the noun, much work to do. So that's why it is an adjective. Okay, coming to the second sentence, that is sentence number B, there is much to do, means lot to do. It is telling you the degree of work you have to do, that is much, so it is an adjective. Okay, both are adjectives. Coming to the next sentence, that is sentence number C in 2A, 2C, he is much loved member of the family. Now here you see it is telling you about the love. Love is a verb. How he is loved? He is much loved. Everybody loved him. Very adorable person in the family. So telling you more about love, so this is an adverb. Much loved. Okay? So it is also a degree of adverb. Degree of adjective. Of adverb also there. So this is the degree of adverb. So much love is used as adverb. Coming to the third set of sentences, there are also 3 sentences. Number 3A, the ships are near the pool. Now here near is underlined, and you have to tell us that whether it is which part of speech is it. Now the ships are and the port. What is the relation between the ship and the port? What is the relationship between the ship and the port? The ships are near the port, so it is giving you the relationship, that's why it is a preposition. next module.